This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant and apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ in Dallas and Fort Worth, Texas, sent by God to your house to declare to you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15, 3 and 4 tell us what the gospel is. How that Jesus Christ died for our sins, according to Scripture, he was buried, and he rose again the third day, according to Scripture. Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He's anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the broken heart, preach deliverance to the captives, recover the sight to the blind, set at liberty them that are bruised. The word is nigh thee. Even as your heart and your mouth is the word of faith. So I preach, you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. With the heart, man believeth unto righteousness. With the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. There's the power of God unto salvation. Everyone that believeth, the Jew first, also to the Greek, therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by his faith. Amen. I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast. Receiving it on live stream, Roku, Apple TV, YouTube, and other devices. Thank God. And shortwave radio. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. On my right, co-host Jerry Brown. Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you. On my left, co-host Kathie Davidson. Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you. On the wire, Colorado, Kathy Courier. Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you. And on the wire, Tennessee, Mount Julia, Cindy Barber. Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you. Let's have the wire girls. What do you say? Hallelujah. Everybody set? Ready to move out?
Amen.
Really? Well, let's start with Terry and Kathie by come let us worship King.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, come to the place, to the one who raised from the dead. Oh, come and see the risen King. For he is our God and greatly to be praised.
Are all passed away. He that sat upon them
of kings, the Lord of lords, He's everything. Messiah, Jehovah, the Prince of Peace is He. The Son of Man, Seed of Abraham, the Redeemer of humanity.
How would you like the fourth man?
Yes. Amen. Amen.
story from the good book we know. A story about a miracle that happened long ago. We hope that you'll take courage when temptations you meet. There's somebody watching you who's strong when you're weak.
They wouldn't be.
They held up to the will of God, so we are told.
They wouldn't bow.
They would not bow their knee to the idol made of gold.
They wouldn't bend.
They were protected by the fourth man in the fire. They wouldn't bend, they wouldn't bow, they wouldn't burn. The prophet Daniel tells about three men who walked with God. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego before the wicked king they stood. And the king commanded them bound and thrown in the fiery furnace that day. And the fire so hot that the man was slain that forced them on their way.
They wouldn't bend.
They held up to the will of God, so we are told.
They wouldn't bow.
They would not bow their knee to the idol made of gold.
They wouldn't bend.
They were protected by the fourth man in the fire. They wouldn't bend, they wouldn't bow, they wouldn't burn. When the fear cast in and the king rose up to witness their awful fate, he began to tremble at what he saw, and astonished tones he spake. If we not cast three men all bound into the midst of the fire, lo, I see four men unhurt, unbound, and walking down there. There's Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, and the fiery coals they trod. In the form of the fourth man, I see as like the Son of God.
They wouldn't bend.
They held up to the will of God, so we are told.
They wouldn't bow.
They would not bow their knee to the idol made of gold.
They wouldn't bend.
They were protected by the fourth man in the fire. They wouldn't bend, they wouldn't bow, they wouldn't burn.
They wouldn't bend.
They held up to the will of God, so we are told.
They wouldn't bow.
They would not bow their knee to the idol made of gold.
They wouldn't burn.
They were protected by the fourth man in the fire. They wouldn't bend, they wouldn't bow, they wouldn't burn.
They would bend.
They held up to the will of God, so we are told.
They would not bow.
They would not bow their knee to the idol made of gold.
They would burn.
They were protected by the fourth man in the fire. They wouldn't bend, they wouldn't bow, they wouldn't burn.
Would you be interested in taking some land with Prairie My, one of my boys? Are you ready?
Amen.
Oh,
righteousness and the Lamb who was slain. You're the lily of the valley. You're my bright and morning star. You're the beginning and the end, the everlasting Father. You're the God of all glory. You're my healer and the King of kings, my deliverer and my friend. You're the sweet rose of Sharon. You're a love, you're a power. You're merciful and you're mighty. You're the Redeemer of all mankind. You're the Lion of Judah. You're the ruler of this whole universe. You're the Most High Messiah. You're the soon coming King. Holy, holy is your name.
We worship and adore.
Things to say as well. Kathie, book of Joel.
Great. I'm going to read from the book of Joel, chapter 2. I'm going to begin in verse 23. Be glad then, you children of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your God, for he has given you the former rain moderately, and he will cause to come down for you the rain, the former rain and the latter rain in the first month. And the floors shall be full of wheat, and the vats shall overflow with wine and oil. And I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the cankerworm and the caterpillar and the palmerworm, my army, my great army, which I sent among you. And you shall eat in plenty and shall be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord your God that hath dealt wonderfully with you, and my people shall never be ashamed. And you shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I am the Lord your God and none else, and my people shall never be ashamed. And it shall come to pass afterwards that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions. And also upon the servants and upon the handmaids in those days will I pour out my spirit. And I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and terrible day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be deliverance, as the Lord has said, and in the remnant whom the Lord shall call.
Glory. What a glorious promise.
Amen.
God sent a great army among his people. Cankerworm, palmerworm, caterpillar, locust. And every one of them did some eating. There's some destruction. You know what? God is going to restore.
Amen.
Whether cankerworm ate, whether caterpillar ate,
amen,
whether locust ate, amen. Thank God. One more. What is it? I named it.
The locust, cankerworm, caterpillar, and palmerworm.
Palmerworm. Amen. Folks, God is not through with us.
Amen.
No, you're not going to go forth without restoration. Oh, what a blessing that this is, that the palmerworm, what he ate, got to be restored. What the cankerworm ate has to be destroyed. What the locust ate has to be destroyed. Amen. Thank God. Look, God has to restore us.
Amen.
Amen. This is a great blessing to us. You thought maybe that you would get by like you are now. No, you're going to be restored. I want to tell you something. I spent years, several, Joel 2:32, praying it. Whosoever shall call by the name of the Lord shall be delivered. That's after our God. Amen.
Amen.
Amazing. Amen. J.D., read those four words.
Those four words, and it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered.
Right. Well, we got the locust, we got the palmerworm, caterpillar, and what's the other?
The cankerworm.
Cankerworm. They've all been some destruction in your soul.
Amen.
God sent them. Now, he's going to restore us. Does that make you any happier?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And my people shall never be ashamed.
Are we ready to go on with Jeremiah?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
it was dark in my heart. You brought light to me, a child of darkness became a child of light. And when my soul was so I'm the Alpha.
lives, saying, is no one worthy to go? For no one in heaven, no one in earth was worthy to open the scroll. Then one of the elders said, John, don't you weep. It was all part of a plan. And there in the middle of God's glorious throne, hallelujah, there stood a man. And they sang, worthy, worthy of honor and praise. They were casting down crowns and praising his name. And he said, are you worthy? I could hear Jesus saying, I am. Oh, praise God forever. There's to the land. Now open your Bible. Open your heart. It's clear we are in the last days. For he said, I'll come quickly. So don't be surprised when he comes back to take us away. And people's excuses won't get very far when
give a joyous shout in the honor of the rock of our salvation. Come before him with thankful hearts. Let us sing him songs of praise. Hallelujah.
Family home to me. And all changed in the twinkling of an eye. Up till now, we've been looking through a glass so dark and dim, and only a few mysteries have we known. But I sense now in my spirit his returning is upon us, and with a shout and God's trumpet we'll be gone. And
glory, Almighty God. in me. Greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Satan's like a roaring lion, roaming to and fro, seeking whom he may devour. The Bible tells me so. Many souls have been his prey, caught in some weak hour. But God has given us today his overcoming power. Greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. On that day of Pentecost, a mighty rushing wind blew into the upper room to baptize all of them with a power greater than anyone had known. And I'm so glad we got it too. I wanna tell the whole wide world. Now tell it with me. Greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. God is greater than the wisest man. Greater than the power of sin. Greater than the gates of hell. Greater than anyone can tell. Greater than the richest king. Greater than anything. Greater, oh, greater, greater, yes, greater. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world.
Put this right here, teach this right here, Joel chapter 2, about restoring all that God's great army that he sent, the palmerworm, cankerworm, caterpillar, locust, that he sent, and the damage they did to us. And God is going to restore all the bay, everything. What a blessing. Now I'm believing this. And I'm believing it. It's going to take place through the power of God, of course. I mean, God's not going to do something different. It's right in the Bible. And in the book of Genesis, Joseph talks about, well, Kathie, would you read Genesis, was it 41?
41.
What happened to Joseph? Would you read it?
Sure will. I'm going to begin in verse 50. And unto Joseph were born two sons before the years of famine came, which Asenath, the daughter of Potipharah, priest of On, bore unto him. And Joseph called the name of the firstborn Manasseh. For God, said he, has made me forget all my toil and all my father's house.
Made him what?
Forget all his toil.
All of what?
His toil.
Toil. That's amazing.
Amen.
That's strong labor.
Amen.
Right?
That's right.
Make him forget Joseph. Now remember something. We are in the tribe of Joseph. I am. God put me there. Jerry heard it. Conversation was present. Years, two or three, whatever it was, in October, how God put me in the tribe of Joseph. And it's got a lot of toil I've been through. Not fun. Not fun. What does God say he's going to do to it?
He said that he's going to name the firstborn Manasseh. For God said he hath made me forget all my toil and all my father's house.
Forget the toil. Oh, am I looking for that? Am I looking forward to forget the toil that I've been through? You, saint, I'm sure. We are in the tribe of Joseph, folks. I am, and I'm sure the people that believe my gospel will be in the tribe of Joseph all over the world. Amen? And things are going to be restored. Thank God. I tell you, this has ministered to me before, but tonight it did some great, it helped. Helped a lot. Thank God. Have you got anything?
Yeah, I want to, the next one, in the name of the second, he called Ephraim, for God has caused me to be fruitful in the land of my affliction.
Amen. Land of affliction?
Land of his affliction, yes.
My goodness. You see what God's going to do? He's got to do this with his power. Look. The toil. You don't know what a blessing that is to me. And how encouraging it is. Doesn't it say he wipes it away?
It says he made me forget.
Forget. I can't wait to forget it. Amen. Are we through?
Amen.
I just thank God for all of you. Thank God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Mercy, grace, mercy, grace, mercy, grace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and the Lord Jesus Christ. Remember, Joel 2 says that you won't be ashamed.
Amen.
After restored. Right?
Amen.
Folks, this is not talking about when you get to heaven. This is talking about now, thank God. Now, amen.
Amen.
And I am happy. God bless you. I will see you tomorrow.
Amen.
Amen.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.